Nobel Prize winners are being announced throughout this week, with the coveted Peace Prize announced on Friday. Teenage climate change activist Greta Thunberg is tipped to win the Peace Prize after her school strike for climate, which reached all corners of the globe, as well as her voyage across the Atlantic. Four South Africans have won the Peace Prize, as Albert Luthuli, Desmond, Tutu, Nelson Mandela and F.W. de Klerk. Meanwhile, the Nobel Prize in Literature will be named on Thursday, winners of both the 2018 and 2019 awards, after it was shelved last year amid a sexual assault scandal that rocked the Swedish Academy. Among the favourites are Canadian poet Anne Carson, novelist Maryse Conde of Guadeloupe, and Kan Shu of China, and Canadian writer Margaret Atwood, author of The Handmaid's Tale, that's been made into a hit TV series. Now, for more on the awards, Olof Somell, curator of the Nobel Prize Museum, joins us here. A very good evening to you, and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for inviting me and having me here.
Thank you. So, as I said, so you've traveled from Stockholm to tell us more about the context and the background behind the Nobel Peace Prize.
Yes, that is correct. The Nobel Prizes are world-renowned, of course, but the intricacies and how they function is not always as well known.
So what are those?
Oh, many. First of all, to note the immense care that is taken in awarding these prizes. It's a process that takes more than a year of meticulous nominations, surveys, investigations, and lots of reading to eventually arrive at the decision.
And I'm sure some dissent along the way in especially choosing somebody like the Nobel Peace Prize awardee.
Yes, I mean, there's definitely dissent. They strive for consensus. Of course, they strive for consensus. But when it comes down to it, it is a majority vote that decides it.
I mean, just looking at what we're talking about, the Nobel Peace Prize, there are several favorites. We'll go into that. By the way, when is that going to be announced, the Nobel Peace Prize Award? Friday?
Friday for the Peace Prize, yes, from Oslo.
So I spoke about Greta Thunberg, and the name Donald Trump was thrown in at some point, and there are quite a few others. And looking at somebody like the U.S. president, somebody who's said to be a very polarizing figure, how do you make somebody like that qualify? Because I know it was the North Korean issue that came up as him being a nominee, but how easy is it to lobby for somebody like that to be considered?
Well, to get nominated is actually fairly easy. Getting nominated is not the hard part. The pool of people that are allowed to nominate for the Nobel Peace Prize is quite large. And it includes, amongst others, all members of national parliaments in the world. So mainly all national politicians can nominate for the Nobel Peace Prize, which means that you will see odd nominations. The hard part isn't that. The hard part is what comes after getting it.
Well, certainly not odd is the nomination of the Ethiopian Prime Minister, the New Zealand Prime Minister as well for this award. Any idea who might come up tops?
I'm notoriously bad at guessing. Over the 50 years I've worked with this, I've been correct.
You're very good at
once.
Being coy about telling us.
Okay. I'm very good at that too.
Okay, so let's talk about the awards that have been given out. They started yesterday,
I think.
Okay, tell us a bit more about
The Medicine Prize to Samantha Radcliffe and Keel. Kaelin, I should say. I'm still learning the names. It's one of the classic sort of physiology prizes. We learned more on how the body functions. What does it do? How does it do what it does? In this particular case, how do cells adjust to more or less oxygen? And this was something that was known that they did, but not how it functioned. The details get technical, so we won't get into them here. But suffice to say that we now, with this research, know more than we did earlier. And the hopes are at least that this can be used in treatments.
Okay. So there's also physics and chemistry that's coming up. Physics is today, if I'm correct.
Yes, physics a few hours ago.
Okay.
If medicine was from the very small, physics this year was from the huge, with one half for research on the structure of the universe, on cosmology, as it's called, and the other one for what I think is rather exciting, the exoplanets. Finding planets around stars that may or may not look like Earth, which these two scientists championed and pioneered how to actually do.
I mean, we know mathematics has also been one that's been keenly looked upon. I spoke about earlier on literature. What about economic sciences?
Economic sciences is coming Monday. This economics is, in a sense, the odd man out in the Nobels, being added later on to the family. The first five instituted by Alfred Nobel, Swedish industrialist, in his last will. The last one in economics added as a memorial award in 1968.
Mm-hmm. What is the importance of a Nobel Prize? I mean, obviously it means a lot amongst your peers to be lauded, recognized by them, but how would you encourage a young person out there who's probably watching this interview who'd want to say that I want to one day be one of those, a Greg Semenza, a Sir Peter Ratcliffe?
Well, for starters, I'd say I'd listen to what they say. And what they almost universally say is, don't go for the award. Go for the science, or go for the discovery, go for the passion. Whether it's literature that you like or science, do that. And if you're really, really lucky, you'll make a great discovery. Mm. And if you're exceptionally lucky, you might get the Nobel Prize.
So is that the ultimate goal, that what you recognize, somebody who has unearthed something that's not been known before, illuminated before?
Yes. The founder, Nobel, said in his will, he wanted the prizes awarded to those who have conferred the greatest benefit on humankind. And I think it's that really inspires the entire Nobel Prizes. What can be done? How can humanity be better? Whether it's with knowledge or actual applications. Mm.
So if Greta Thunberg is to win on Friday, would she be the youngest Nobel Peace Prize winner?
Maybe. I'm not entirely certain how old she is. She might probably 50. Be slightly older than Malala Yousafzai.
Okay, I actually thought Malala was
similarly the same
older
age.
Years. Yes, okay.
But other than those, there is a gap up to the next one.
All right, just a quick final question. So you're here in South Africa to also do part of the work for the foundation. So tell us a little bit more about what you'll be doing for the Academy.
Right now I'm here talking then about the Nobel Prizes, and this is a large part of what I do to spread the gospel, in a sense, talk about the Nobel Prizes. And I'm doing this here together with the Swedish Embassy and the National Research Foundation in a series of events.
All right, great. Thank you very much for joining us. Mr. Olof Somell is curator at the Nobel Prize Museum in Stockholm. And we're going to take a quick break. Don't go ahead.